FBI arrested terror suspect Christopher Lee, Christopher Cornell, at the Point Blank Range West after he purchased two weapons that the FBI says he intended to use in a terror plot. Evan Millward is live and just talked to the manager of the store there. Evan, what do we know?
Township. This is where what was basically a sting operation, as we understand it, by the FBI. They had reached out to the owners and the managers of this gun range and store and said, we're going to have a guy coming in. We want you to sell to him what he is interested in buying, and then we'll take care of it. And so so this man walked in, walked into the store, got two AR-15 rifles, some ammunition, a magazine, and was sold it and didn't make it more than a couple of steps outside the store before the agents tackled him. And then managers tell us he was quickly moved into custody, but there were agents here for a while. They said they've known something was happening for about a week, just saying, hey, we need you to cooperate with us. But they had no idea until about 10 minutes before this happened. They were as surprised as anyone by the news today that this may have some ties to ISIS or to a planned jihad. I specifically asked the manager a little bit earlier when we spoke. I said, when you hear that in these documents, jihad, a guy from Cincinnati, and he just shook his head and said, yeah, it's two things you don't often, never hear in the same sentence. But they say, you know, they played only a small part. That's a first for them, having any kind of part in a law enforcement takedown, as it were, like this. We did do a little bit of an interview with managers earlier. I think we have some of that. We're going to play that for you right now. This is what the folks here at Point Blank West had to say about all of this just a few minutes ago.
Shortly after we opened, we had an agent to stop by the store who said that someone would be coming by to purchase two guns, and they wanted us to go ahead and handle the sale for them. And shortly after he arrived, he identified the person at the door who was going to be coming in, and so I helped the person with the purchase. As soon as the purchase was over and he left the door, several agents came out and tackled him here in the parking lot and took him down. That was basically the whole incident.
What time was that roughly?
It was a little after 10 o'clock today, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you had no idea until...
About 10 minutes before, in. Yeah.
Until 10 minutes before. Did they give you a heads up that they were going to come at all, like before that, or...?
We've been cooperating with local and federal law enforcement for about a week on this. I mean, they'd come by. We had had a discussion. They said that they had a person that may be interested in making a purchase from us and wanted us to keep us in the loop and how we should proceed over the next several days as they made their plans.
What was Mr. Cornell like throughout the whole? I mean, you said you helped him buy the gun. What was he like during that time?
You know, he was a little shy, you know, but talkative. Nothing really out of the ordinary about him at all. Certainly nothing that would indicate that he was involved in something of this magnitude.
Can you give us the inventory again that he was, he came to purchase, or that he did?
Two AR-15 style rifles, semi-automatic civilian rifles, some ammunition, and a couple of magazines.
Do you know how much ammunition?
I don't recall offhand. It was a good amount.
Okay. But nothing that like jumped out to you?
No. I've sold more. I've sold less. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You hear about the plot that he was planning on doing, to know that you guys helped out with this reaction, knowing that you guys were able to step in and help out.
Yep. You know, we had no idea really what he was involved in until much later in the day as the national news started picking up the story. For us, it was a matter of the normal cooperation that we would give to local law enforcement. In the past, you know, there are all kinds of situations that the police might be involved in a situation in terms of gun sales and that sort of thing. And so this didn't necessarily seem like it was such a big thing until after the fact.
And then you kind of hear they throw the word jihad around in some of these documents.
Yeah.
A guy from Cincinnati?
Exactly. You wouldn't think Cincinnati, Ohio, jihadist in the same sentence. But like I said, you know, that's not really a part of our, you know, the piece of the story. I'm just as surprised as everybody else.
Do you guys have any?
So we're back out here live in Colerain Township outside of Point Blank West and Gunshot here. You just saw that was an interview done just a few minutes ago right out here in front of the store. A lot of the folks management-wise are here, very willing to talk about this. They say they were glad to be able to help, but as the details of these charges and this investigation have come out, they're now kind of astonished that they were part of helping take this so-called plot down. Again, we're still talking to some of the folks here. We're going to have more updates for you throughout the evening and on WCPO.com. But until then, we're live in Colerain Township. I'm Evan Millward. Guys, back to you.